Good morning, class 11. So let's complete our reading of the chapter Silk Road, which we are doing from the book Hornbill, written by Nick Middleton. So we're at the last portion. So you know very well that till now we have read that how the narrator and Norbu met. Narrator was happy to see Norbu because he met the first person after Sen who knew English, and there he got to know that he was, although Norbu was Tibetan, but he was working with the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences in Beijing, right? So here let's see what happened. We are on the end of this chapter, page 81. We are going to learn that how narrator and Norbu was there together, how Norbu was writing for the academic papers about the Kailash Gora. Then narrator thought about his positive thinking, started working, and both became their partners for that Kailash Gora. They hired yaks, that is the animal, for carrying the luggage, and they started laughing. Okay, so we are here. So yeah, we have last read about Norbu. "Yes and no," he said, "I have come to do the Gora." My heart jumped. Norbu had been writing academic papers about the Kailash Gora and its importance in various works of Buddhist literature for many years. He told me, but he had never actually done it himself. So he asked that whether you had for the Kailash Gora or not, mention me yes or no. And then there was a description that Norbu was writing for the academic papers about the Kailash Gora. But first time he is visiting, earlier he just used to write about it. Although he was a Tibetan, but he was mentioning about it, the importance of this works in the Buddhist practice or in the Buddhist literature. So he first time came for that. "When the time came for me to tell him what brought me to Darchan, his eyes lit up." So narrator explained that why he came to Darchan. He was there to complete the Gora only. "We could be a team," he said excitedly. So Norbu gave that initiative that we could work as a team. We could complete our Gora together. "Two academics who have escaped from the library. Perhaps my positive thinking strategy was working after all." So two academics basically means Norbu as well as this narrator, because he also used to work in the Academy of Social Sciences, right? So they have they were there, and he said that my positive thinking started working because earlier he was feeling alone. Earlier he felt that don't know that how the things would finish off. "My initial relief at meeting Norbu, who was also staying at the in the guest house, was tempered by the realization that he was almost as ill-equipped as I was for the pilgrimage." So he was satisfied. Narrator was relieved when he got to know that Norbu was also living at the guest place, and even he is having all the things. So he was well-equipped as narrator was with the things which required for the pilgrimage. "He kept telling me how fat he was and how hard it was going to be." So narrator mentioned Norbu used to tell him earlier that how fat he was, and it would be very difficult for him to complete that Gora easily actually. "Very high up," he kept reminding me. "So tiresome to work." So because that Kailash was at the top, so he said it would be very tiring thing for him to walk till there. "He wasn't really a practicing Buddhist, it transpired, but he had enthusiasm and he was of course Tibetan." So yeah, he was not the follower of Buddhist. He was not the one who used to follow it. But as he was Tibetan, he had that intho to complete that or to do that. "Although I had originally envisaged making the trek in the company of devout believers, on reflection, I decided that perhaps no would turn out to be the ideal companion." Now he said, although I was predicting it, that I really want the believers with whom I can complete my Gora. He predicted that. He envisaged about. But when he met Norbu, he thought that he would be my best companion to reach there. He suggested, now Norbu suggested him, we should hire some yaks to carry our luggage, because there was a huge luggage. So we should hire some yaks, the animals which look like the ox one, which I interpreted as a good sign, and he had no intention of frustrating himself all round the mountain. So even narrator agreed on it, he said, in Norbu, that he basically, Norbu also had no intention of prostrating himself all around the mountain, because Norbu had no intention to just lie down, to surrender for completing this Gora. So he thought it would be better to take the help for carrying out the luggage instead of feeling to lie down or to feel surrender to basically can't do anything. "Not possible," he cried. collapsing across the table in hysterical laughter. So they were sitting there in that cafe only. So he started laughing, he collapsed, and he just, in a hysterical, in the emotional tone, not emotional, sorry, in the uncontrollable tone, he laughed about that how the scorer would finish because of his fat and all. It wasn't his style, and anyway, his tummy was too big. So although it was not for of his style, but as his tummy was too big, he was so fat in that way, he thought about it. So here we finish off Silk Road. So here, then after that, their journey got completed and all. But how he met Norbu and how he became friend of that is very important to understand. So if any doubt still you are having in your mind, just clear it out your doubt. Ask from me if anything is there, we can clear it out. And you just need to understand that how they became friends and how they thought about to complete their quota. So in the next class, we will discuss other questions too about it. So I really hope it's clear to you, and send the work timely. God bless you.